Can't wait to get it open. Let's get it cracked and into a glass. See what it's all about.
Close it down.
Yeah.
Close it down.
I'm thinking,
James. I was going to crawl in
there. That'd be fun, wouldn't it?
This is from Portland, Oregon, and it's a rare and unique craft beer location in the US of A. I'm joined by Adam from Adam Craft Beers, Rob from Obsidiany. This is a Cascade Strawberry Ale. It's barrel aged with vanilla and strawberries. We've seen Goose Island do this, that they have fruits in some of their barrel beers. Like the Bourbon County Range, they did, I don't know if it was one of them. They're probably their creeks. They add fruits to the barrels just to.
It's a little bit
so
lively.
So it's a bit of a gusher.
A little bit lively. I think I coped with that quite well.
That looks beautiful that's coming out of the top of the bottle, though, that, doesn't it? I mean.
It's like a Friday night in a porn club.
let's pour some of this whilst we're...
But yeah, and some people do add... I think Atom Beers, you mentioned they have added fruit to some of their barrels.
It smells great.
Yeah, it does, you're right. It smells awesome. It smells like...
I mean, do you think this is a growing thing? Because sometimes when you put something in barrels, it soaks up so much sweetness.
Well, fruit, I guess, that's
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah.
Brewery fruit, I mean, there's always that kind of like... situation where, and this has travelled a long way, there might be that kind of like spot on its journey that sat in some kind of like...
My first ever Cascade Brewery beer.
Yeah, it might have sat somewhere for a bit too long, slightly.
Have you managed to have any Cascade beers before?
This is the first time I've ever had
what?
One.
What?
Yeah.
First for all
and
beers.
And really brought some... I've had one before.
He is the poshest beer.
Rob also has a raspberry version of this, but we chose a strawberry today, so... That looks like
fair bit of sediment in mine.
Yeah.
We've had strawberry infused beers before, all of us, in different formats. But yeah, you do pick up elements of the strawberry colour. And if you do ground... when we reviewed one strawberry beer, they do add it for body in some beers, strawberry, and it has that wheat balance on the back end for strawberry beers.
Maybe that's the haziness, you know, the wheat that's added.
Well, obviously we can smell it.
Yeah.
From a mile off.
Whoa.
For me, it smells...
from a distance, though, it smells like strawberry chapstick.
Well, from the kind of the amount that I spilled at the table, for me, it smelled like kind of strawberry-flavoured, like seaside rock.
Yeah.
But
it's really kind of tart, isn't it? It's really acidic
and
tart.
We don't get that many variations of strawberry-infused craft beers. They choose a lot of the time raspberries because they're a cheaper, almost fruit to have.
Strawberries are funny one. Yeah. Strawberries are often quite a synthetic flavour.
It's a lot of water in the fruit because it soaks up, most like mushrooms, it soaks up so much water.
Yeah.
I mean, you have to pick the right kind of strawberries to pick out for the flavours.
It's a bit kind of... barnyard, it's a little bit kind of funky, a little bit kind of like ratty around the edges, fruity.
I know people are going to disagree with me here, but it reminds me a little bit of the aroma of Rosé de Gambrinus.
Maybe a little bit,
Just a touch.
Well, I've got a good amount of sediment,
I can imagine. I think
this is
going to
sit for a while before the rest of it gets poured out, imagine.
Yeah.
Should we get into it?
Cheers.
It's a little bit lively, but whatever. Mmm.
Oh yeah.
See, that's got a real kind of sharp lactic kind of like.
That just like sounds like saliva coming out of my mouth. I can't control it.
It's weird when you drink it and you get that dryness.
Really dry.
If you lick lips shortly after, you get that saltiness in the aftertaste.
Yeah, you do. You're right.
Salt and lemon juice. Ooh, yeah.
Yes. I mean, some of the
I like
beer cocktails, you have salt covering the glass like a margarita.
There's a little bit of kind of like a cider vinegar going on there as well.
Yeah, definitely. It's not. Yeah, it's definitely apple cider vinegar rather than balsamic. Yeah. Is it like a brune or a sour brown or anything like that?
I mean, Cascade specialise in this kind of.
Yeah,
I don't know. I have not.
Yeah, no, there's quite a lot of snobbery regarding. The Cascade beers. There's like a lot of kind of like snobbish online groups kind of say this stuff's a bit like a salad dressing or something.
Yeah.
But I think it's lovely. I mean, it is very lacto heavy. I mean, it's got, you get that sharp kind of like natural yogurt kind of like.
Where do they actually get the name from? Because these are not called Cascade.
There's the mountains in the Cascade.
Oh, okay. Wow. Also, it's basically the way everything flows. It's basically a Cascade effect.
I presume that.
Yeah. So I'm guessing it's like. You say with mountains, they've come off that name. It's pretty cool that they use the local name.
I think this is probably the best.
Do you know what that is?
Strawberry beer I've ever had. Because damn, strawberry beer is like fruity and shit like that, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
But it's a really nice, sharp, citric sour beer.
But it's balanced very well with the vanilla sweetness, don't you think? It's
I've not thought about a bit of vanilla at all.
No, but the thing is, it makes an appearance for me because it almost balances out and doesn't make it too dry on the back end, so that you're not wanting to go back to it every 2 seconds. I know this sounds very strange to a lot of people who drink a lot of sour beers, but it's a very well balanced fruity sour ale, if you can get such a thing.
Yeah.
I think this is a good example of that. I think the strawberries, the vanilla, and also the goza like sour quality kind of blends very well together.
Yeah.
I think they've got that quite accurate, and I'm quite impressed, and I'd love to try some more stuff by Cascade.
As it turns out, I've got a raspberry one downstairs.
Well, that's funny, isn't it?
Another time. So that is a bottle of Cascade Brewing's Cascade Sour. 7 points, what did I say?
Hey, you don't get a drop of 7.56
ABV.
No.
Kind of, but they call it.
It's always nice to try a brand new brewery.
Sour style ale with vanilla beans and strawberries. Lovely stuff. See you in a bit.
See you next time.
Cheers.
Cheers.